Boganandeshwara Temple, situated in Nandi village at the base of the popular Nandi hills in Chikbalapur in the state of Karnataka. The Boganandeshwara Temple has a history that dates back to 1300 years ago. The Boganandeshwara Temple is built in the 9th century. It's well known for its splendid Dravidian architecture, the amazing scenic backdrop, and most importantly, for the lingas situated in the temple. This 1300-year-old temple bears the architectural stamps of 5 different dynasties that ruled here, namely Ganga dynasty, Cholas, Vaisalas, Pallavas, and Vijayanagara kings. The temple is believed to have been originally constructed by the Bana queen Ratnavali, and each dynasty has made its construction to the addition and intention of the temple, such as in the 11th century the Chola kings added the roof, the Hoysala dynasty added the marriage hall, outer walls and buildings were added by the Vijayanagara kings in the 13th century. The Boganandeshwara temple is known to house 4 Shivalingas, while 3 are situated in the temple. One is situated in the Yoganandeshwara temple that is located on top of the Nandi hills. These lingas are known to symbolize the life cycle, with each lingas symbolizing the stages or periods in the cycle. Namely, Kammateshwara Linga indicates childhood, called as Balya. Arunachaleshwara Linga indicates young age, called as Yavana. Boganandeshwara Linga indicates youth, called as Vardhika. Yoganandeshwara Linga indicates old age, called as Bhupu. The biggest linga among these is the Boganandeshwara Linga, which indicates the age of youth and a time to rejoice and enjoy life. Hence, festivals and celebrations are held in this temple. In contrast, the Yoganandeshwara Linga, which is located on top of Nandi Hills, is the smallest and has no festivals at all, as it signifies the old age. The temple structure also houses the Uma Maheshwara, which depicts Shiva and Parvati's wedding. The temple is often visited by young couples and newly married couples to receive blessings. The main attraction in this temple is the idol of Shiva and Parvati, which is sculptured from one single stone. The temple pond, called as Sringi Tirtha, is surrounded on all 4 sides by a walkway and a running mantapa. There are steps leading down to the pond on all 4 sides. The other 2 major sculptures in the temple are Vasanta Mantapa and Kalyana Mantapa. The temple is spread across 14 acres of land, with the temple structure occupying 7 acres and the rest by the garden in front of the temple building. It is also surrounded by 5 hills which are the sources of 5 different rivers, namely Palar, Penakini, Akravati, Papagini and Swarnamukhi. Nandi, or also known as Basavanna, is Lord Shiva's Vahana or vehicle. The Nandi idol is located 2 kilometers away from the temple, is biggest in India, which is present from the 11th century. There is a belief that the gigantic size of the Nandi or Basava is a result of natural growth and it wasn't made this big. Hence, it is also known as Udbhava Murti. There is a rooster stone placed in front of the Nandi idol, which is believed to create some sort of sound to indicate the warning about a natural disaster or a dangerous event.
ಇಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಬಸವಣ್ಣ ಯಾಕಪ್ಪ ದೊಡ್ಡದು ಅಂತ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಕಲ್ಲಿನ ಕೋಳಿ ಇತ್ತು, ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಬಸವಣ್ಣ ಇತ್ತು. ಆಗಿನ ಕಾಲದ ಒಂದು ಇದ್ರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅಂದರೆ ಹಿರಿಯರ ಒಂದು ಮಾತಿನ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಕಲ್ಲಿನ ಕೋಳಿ ಕೂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಏನೋ ಪ್ರಳಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದೇನೋ ಒಂದು ಕೆಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಅನುಭವ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸೂಚನೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಯಾರೋ ಬಂದರು ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಹೊರಟೋದ್ರು, ಸಿಕ್ಕಲಿಲ್ಲ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದು. ಮತ್ತು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಆ ಬಸವಣ್ಣಗೆ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಇದು ಮಾತಿದೆ.
ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಅಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ.